by singing and composing songs, I kind of get the pressure off of me. Anybody can sing a song, but I try to live each song. And in my mind, I guess I really try to remember what it was like.
Penitentiary blues. All that marijuana, selling cocaine. Now they're taking blood tests from my heroin veins, oh baby. Things I used to do now.
This is David Allan Coe, a man who knows lonely, a man who can appreciate sad, happy, bad times, good times. He's an ex-con, 29 years old, and the possessor of a 20-year record of existing behind stone walls and steel bars. At the age of 9, David became the product of a broken home, being pushed from one relative to another, and finally becoming a ward of the state. The remainder of his prison record reads basically the same as any other man's who's lived a life behind bars. But the lonely hours of time brought Coe to write and sing songs of prison life, prison death. Songs that earned him the name, The Singer. Recently, things have begun looking better for David Allan Coe. He still writes and sings songs. A major recording company has recorded an album and given him an incentive to be something that he once only dreamed of being. However, Coe's outlook is still basically unchanged.
Well, you know, I want things like everybody else, you know, a Cadillac and things, but then, like, I've got a foster brother in Ohio that's just started a program for convicts in prison. It's called a 7-step organization. It's from Akron, Ohio. I've also got another thing in the making now. We're trying to clear the name on it. It's called Ex-Con Anonymous, and it's for a publishing company to start my own publishing company, and we'll just accept material from cats that's in prison that's on parole, you know,
that's
songs
really good,
and things like that.
That's really good. I bet you pick up a lot of good material from them, too.
There's a lot of good material in prison. There's a lot of talented people.
There's a lot of good people in prison, too, I bet you.
Well, there's a lot of good people, and there's a lot of bad people.
I got a couple of friends in there, too. I tell you, man, you really got some good material, man, and it couldn't happen to a better cat, man.
Well, coming from you, man, you know, like, you've wrote some of the heaviest songs. Like, when I was, you know, a teenager, man, like, the songs that they was playing, you was writing them, man. So I really take that as a compliment.
Well, thank you, man. I'll take that as a compliment, too, man.
You know, it worries me, like, about the country tunes that I do, you know, whether people's really going to be able to accept an entertainer that sings country music and sings hard rock and sings blues and everything all in one, you know, instance and in one show, whether they're really going to be able to identify with the, you know, with
Amy,
the
whole
like
thing about me and about you and the people, man, is that right off the bat, man, they're going to know that they ain't listening to no plastic made-up thing. They're going to know that they're listening to a man who's lived through it and this is the real thing, you know?
Well, I
that's what makes you, your original man, and that's what it takes.
Working on the coal pile, busting rocks at night, working me to death for false sense, and now you know that isn't right. Oh warden, have mercy on me, please. I'm in this penitentiary, begging on bended knee. Scrub floors in the daytime, bust rocks by the moon. When I go to the mess hall, gotta eat my meat with a spoon. Oh, warden, have mercy on me, please. I'm in this penitentiary, begging on bended knee. I hear you, Teddy.
David Allan Coe is an unusual man. A man with 20 years of prison, 300 songs, and 365 tattoos behind him. Before him, a future of much success if the great odds of the hit record happens. As Shelby S. Singleton of Shelby Singleton Corporation thinks it will.
Boss man says I'm lazy. I try not to frown. I know if I make him angry, he'll knock me down on the ground. Oh, warden, have mercy on me, please. I'm in this penitentiary, begging on bended knee.
For 20 years, David Allan Coe was told when to get up, go to bed, when, where, and how to work. Things haven't changed much. However, now his days and nights, and his future, are being carefully planned and mapped in hopes of his becoming a star.
In years in prison, there's no one left to care. 10 long years in prison, there's no one left to care. Ride that train out in the morning, got a one-way ticket to nowhere. Might go to Chicago, maybe Alabama. If I never get to New York, baby, I wouldn't give a damn. 10 long years in prison, there's no one left to care. Ride that train out in the morning, got a one-way ticket to nowhere.
David Allan Coe has traded his coarse convict clothes and square-toe shoes for body shirts, bell-bottoms, and pointed-toe boots. His 20 years behind bars have given him a background that very few people would try, even for a recording contract. David's known it all. Booze, dope, crime, and even the desolation of Death Row, where he spent 12 days.
Me and money for my fare. Gonna leave my past behind me. Got a one-way ticket to nowhere.
David Allan Coe, a different type of man.
Might go to Chicago.
Maybe a lonely man.
Maybe
a sad man. Maybe a happy man.
York, baby,
some good times and some bad times, but not behind prison bars. He's traded his prison number for a number on an LP record, Penitentiary Blues.
Got a one-way ticket to nowhere.